Okay, so we're looking at the second year stats and mechanics textbook, and we're on chapter six, which is projectiles, and we're looking at exercise 6D, which is on projectile formulae. Okay, so we're on question six, so it's an exam question, quite a long one as well, 12 marks, and a problem-solving one. So yeah, if it gets too long, we might split this one up over a couple of videos. We'll see how we go. So particle, let's get this drawn. Let's just look at the first part. Okay, so hopefully, if you've worked through the rest of this, this is starting to look pretty familiar now. So, projected at an angle of elevation of alpha with an initial velocity of u. So, what is going to happen is it's going to follow that kind of path until it hits the ground again. Okay, and we are talking about just a certain position on it where we're calling the vertical, sorry, the horizontal, sorry, the vertical height, y, and its horizontal displacement, x. So that's just a random point on the on its journey that I've just used to illustrate that. Okay, so I need to think horizontally and vertically separately. Okay, so horizontally, its displacement in the horizontal direction we're told to call x. Its initial velocity is, so that's its initial horizontal velocity, so that is going to be u, and I'm adjacent to the angle alpha, so that's going to be u cos alpha. Horizontally, its acceleration is sorry, horizontally, its acceleration is zero, and time, I'm just going to call t. So this has already come up in a couple of questions, quite a common idea. So I'm just going to call the time t, and I don't need to call it the horizontal time. It's the same, so it's the same point in time whether I'm looking horizontally or vertically. So I could use SUVAT, but as we don't consider, we don't worry about things like air resistance. Its horizontal acceleration is zero, so I could use s equals ut plus a half at squared, or I could make things a little bit simpler just by using s equals vt, because as there's no acceleration, it's just a constant velocity. So that initial velocity will be its velocity at any point horizontally. So s, which we're calling x, is its velocity, which is a constant capital U cos alpha times time. Okay, so that's my equation for x. Then let's think what's happening vertically. So there I was taking right as positive. Now I'm going to take up as positive. So they're telling me to call its vertical displacement y. Yeah, that's what they're telling me to call its displacement in that direction. Its vertical initial velocity, so its initial velocity upwards, well, that is opposite alpha, so that's going to be u sine alpha. So its initial vertical velocity is capital U sine alpha, and that's not constant because its acceleration vertically is due to gravity, and if I'm taking up as positive, that's going to be minus g and t. I'm just calling t. Okay, so displacement, acceleration, and velocity will be different whether you're looking, depending on whether you're looking vertically or horizontally, but time is just time. Okay, so if I use s is ut plus a half at squared, so s we're calling y, u is capital U sine alpha, t is t, a half a is a half times minus g, so let's just call that minus a half g, and t we're just calling t. Okay, so that's my equation in y. Okay, and that's actually what I want. I do want an equation with y as the subject, but I just want it to be in terms of x and not in terms of t. So that's easily dealt with. If you've done some of the earlier questions, you've already done this a couple of times. I just want to take this equation make T the subject. So X over U cos alpha is T. And then I want to substitute that in for T. Okay, so I'm going to go back to my equation in Y. So Y is U sine alpha, and then where it says T, I'm going to substitute in X over U cos alpha minus a half G, and then again where it says T, I'm going to substitute in, so I see that, so X equals U cos alpha, and then that's all squared. Okay, and then I'm going to hope, because I'm pretty much there, I'm just going to hope I can get that to simplify down. So U over U can cancel, and sine alpha over cos alpha is tan alpha, so we're okay, we've got that first bit. So I've got the X tan alpha, so that's fine. So let's just look at this second bit. So I've got half G, so let's write that as G over 2. Let's square out those brackets. So in the numerator, that'll just be X squared. In the denominator, it'll be U squared. And then you know from your trig identities that when we're doing cos alpha squared, we write it as, or so when we're doing cos of alpha all squared, we write it as cos squared alpha. So hopefully we can get what they've got. So yeah, we've got the GX squared, so our numerator is fine. We've got the 2u squared, so I just need to deal with that cos squared alpha. So, before I write that out again, let's just justify how cos squared is going to turn to 1 plus tan squared. So let's do that over here. Right, so, well, it's not a cos squared, is it? It's a 1 over cos squared. So 1 over cos squared, I know, is sec squared from my trig identities. And also from my trig identities, I know that sec squared is 1 plus tan squared. So I could possibly just get away. So, you know, if ever you get a bit stuck on a question, always write the final result out, because, you know, you should show that. But you might even get away with just going from that to the final result. You never know. But obviously that's only if you can't sort of justify it. You should really show that working there. So I've got the numerator, I've got the denominator of 2u squared, and we have just justified that 1 over cos squared is sec squared, which is 1 plus tan squared, which, just double check, I haven't written anything silly. Nope, which is exactly what they wanted. Okay, lovely. Right, so an athlete throws a javelin from point P at a height of 2 meters above the horizontal ground. Okay, so we're probably going to be able to use our previous answer. So let's just sketch out what's happening here. So so the athlete is throwing the javelin from a height of 2 meters above the ground. So obviously that's the height, their height, plus the fact their arm's probably in the air. So it's gonna go, and then come back and hit the ground. So I can't see what I'm drawing, it doesn't help. Right, okay, so that's my very bad drawing of what's happening with this javelin. So it started at a height of 2 meters. The angle of elevation was 45 degrees. And the velocity at that angle, the initial speed of that angle, was 30 meters per second. Okay, so this is pretty much the same situation that we just did our general result for. It's just that we've got this 2 meters in the air. So find the three significant figures, the horizontal distance traveled by the javelin when it hits the ground. Okay, so that distance there, basically. We could restart the whole thing. So particularly if you've got really stuck on part A, you could just answer part B as a completely separate question with all that information. But that would take a little bit longer than it should, because basically I've got this equation in terms that gives me Y in terms of X. So if I can figure out what Y is, so this is where it hits the ground. It's hitting the ground 2 meters below where it started from. So at that point, y is minus 2. Okay, so then, and I've been given alpha, and I've been given, well, x is what I'm trying to find. So I've been given alpha, I've been given u. So as long as I can kind of look at that and sketch it out and justify that y is minus 2, I can just use that equation. Right, so I'm going to write the whole thing out again. I'll just lift it from here. So y is minus 2, we've just said. X is what I'm trying to find. Tan alpha, well, they've told me that alpha is 45. So that'll be tan 45 minus g, which is 9.8, times x squared, which is what I'm trying to find, all over 2u squared. And they told me that u is 30. And then all times 1 plus tan 45 all squared. So I'm just going to be really careful when I enter this into the calculator that I enter it correctly. So I know that looks quite nasty, but actually it is just a quadratic. I've got a term in x and a term for x squared. So let's just tidy all that up. So one of the earlier questions, I think I rounded a bit too much, so I won't do that this time. So tan 45 is 1. Well, so we need a calculator for that, so that's not a problem. So that actually just equals x. So what's going to happen here? So yeah, so tan 45 is 1, so I don't need to worry about the squaring so much. So those brackets will equal 2 times 9.8 divided by 2 and divided by 30 squared. Okay, so that's giving me, I've typed that incorrectly. Okay, let's go for that. So let's take everything over to the left-hand side and stick that in the quadratic solve mode in my calculator. Oh, you can't see what I'm writing, sorry. Right, so let's stick that into the quadratic solve mode in my calculator. So 0.010, I'm a bit ahead of myself, right. Make sure I'm in the right mode to start with. Okay, 0.010889. Minus 1, minus 2. Okay, so that's giving me 93.8, and I'm expecting a negative solution, yet minus 1.96. So that one just doesn't make sense, but I was expecting a negative solution because basically there's one back there. It just doesn't make sense in the context of this question. So that's my value for x. And then find two significant figures, the time elapsed from the point the javelin is thrown to the point where it hits the ground. Okay, so that's actually quite straightforward because remember what we said back up here, when we're looking here horizontally, the acceleration is zero. So in fact, even better than that, I've got that equation for t. So I'll just write that down again. I've really forgotten what it said, right, hang on. So it said t is x over u cos alpha. So t is x over capital U cos alpha. Well, we've just figured out that x is 93.8. U, they told me in the question, was 30 and alpha was 45. So 30 plus 45, so this is why it's only worth 2 marks. If you spot that, it's just a quick calculation. So 30 times cos 45. I'm hoping it's 4.42 seconds. Okay, so it's just, fingers crossed, 4.4. Okay, so they've rounded to two significant figures and we've got the 93.8, thank goodness for that.